To access the onion skin feature in Storyboard Pro, you can go to the onion skin toolbar at the top and click on the onion skin button. You can also access the onion skin feature by going to the top menu and selecting View, Onion Skin, Show Onion Skin, or using the keyboard shortcut listed beside. As you can see, a red and green image appear, and these represent the drawings from the panel previous and the panel next. So the green colored image represents the drawing in the next panel, whereas the red colored image represents the drawing in the previous panel. And the reason that we see the red in solid colors is because there's a white fill to these drawings. So were I to delete this white fill, from each of these three layers, you can now see that the onion skinning shows more of an outline with the gray shadow, but it doesn't have that solid colored green or red because I deleted that fill. So obviously lines and fills and the darkness of lines and fills affect how you see the onion skinning. If you decide that you don't like the color red to represent the previous drawing and green to represent the next drawing, you can always change these colors by going to the preferences, by going to the top menu and selecting Storyboard Pro, Preferences if you're using Mac, or Edit Preferences if you're using Windows. And then from the Preferences panel in the Colors tab, you can go to the Onion Skin Color Before and Onion Skin Color After swatches to change those colors. And you simply need to click on the swatch, change the color here, click OK, and then click OK from the Preferences dialog box. In order to change the number of previous drawings that you see and next drawings that you see, you have to go to these little drop-down menus in the Onion Skin toolbar. So the first one, red, represents the drawings that were before, and right now we only have previous panel selected. However, you could have no previous panel selected, which eliminates from view the drawing in the panel previous, or you can do the opposite and have up to three panels before. And the reason that it doesn't show up is because the onion skinning feature works only for the panels of that scene. So for example, there are only three panels in this scene, and the onion skinning feature will not show you what's in the scene before or in the next scene. So if we actually scroll through our project to these panels right here of scene 20, there are actually a lot more, so there's actually nine. Which will make it a better example. So if I click on this panel right here, you'll start to see that it's possible to see more than one previous drawing. And let me just turn off the next drawing feature so we're just paying attention to one color for now. And as I move down the line, you'll notice right away that this light explosion became paler. So here it's a bit darker and here it's a bit paler, and that's because in order to differentiate between the panels that are previous, and this also of course works for the next panels as well, the color progressively washes out. So if this explosion of light is only one panel away, it's slightly darker. However, by panel 7, this light explosion panel is two panels away, so it's slightly paler. And what we see here in darker red is the arm from the panel just prior. The last thing I'd like to talk about is this icon right here that appears on all the layers when the onion skin is enabled. So were I to disable the onion skin, you'll notice that the icon has disappeared. And one more thing that I need to do to make this example more clear is re-enable all the background layers. So if we go back to the panel that was previously selected, which was panel 7 of 9, and we turn off its background layer from view, you'll notice that its background has turned white, despite the fact that the onion skinning should show the backgrounds of the three panels prior. But the reason that they are not being shown is because all of those backgrounds have been marked with that red icon. And this is way more efficient than going through these nine panels and turning off all of the background layers. It's much easier just to mark them and then turn off the background layer from the panel that you're actually working on. And you can actually mark multiple layers as backgrounds. As long as all the layers of the scene are marked in the same way, then they will be excluded from the onion skin. And as you can see, marking a layer as a background is as easy as clicking on this icon to either have it marked or leave it unmarked.